Yes. Good afternoon, students. We are going to start a new chapter, Reproduction in Animals. Our life is a series of processes. Several life processes take place within the body, like digestion, excretion, blood circulation, in plants photosynthesis, like the another life processes, reproduction is also a life processes. Life is very important, but it is true that one day we have to leave this beautiful world. Understand? One day will come when we will leave this beautiful world and we will complete our life span. But it doesn't mean there will be no life on this earth. Understand? The life will be continued. Life will be continued on the earth. The death takes an organism away from the earth, and the reproduction adds the new organisms on the earth. Therefore, life will be continued on the earth. Understand? So that is why reproduction is very essential. Understand? Without reproduction, we will not die. Like without digestion, without blood circulation, we will not survive. But reproduction, without reproduction, we will not die. But it is essential for the survival of life. Let us see the importance of reproduction. Reproduction is essential for survival of life on this earth. Life will be continue on this earth due to reproduction. Death will take an organism away from the earth, and in the other hand, the reproduction will add the new organism. Understand? The second, reproduction is essential for the continuation of a species. What do you mean by the species? The species is a group of similar individuals which live together in a particular place and interbreed in nature to produce their offspring. We belong to a species, our species, the dog's species, cat's species, plant's species, understand? This is the meaning of species. The similar individuals are called species, which can interbreed in nature to produce offspring of same kind. The first importance of this reproduction is, reproduction is essential for survival of this earth, and the second is, reproduction is essential for the continuation of a species. Understand? We can classify the reproduction in two categories. One is the sexual reproduction, and other is the asexual reproduction. Understand? Now try to understand what is sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. sexual reproduction. In this, the mode of reproduction in which two parents are required. The mode of reproduction, this is the mode of reproduction in which two parents are required. You will ask, what is the meaning of the two parents? One is the male parent and female, means father and female mother. These are the two parents. Why two parents are required? Because reproduction begins from the fusion of male gamete and female gamete. Male gamete is the sperm and the female gamete is egg or ovum. The male gamete comes from the father side and the female gamete, egg, comes from the mother side. When male and female gamete sperm and female gamete ovum fertilize a new structure, zygote is formed. Understand? When the male gamete and female gamete fuse together, this is called fertilization. Understand? Clear the fertilization. What is fertilization? You can define it like the fusion of male gamete and female gamete is called fertilization. We can again classify the fusion of male gamete and female gamete is called fertilization. There are two types of fertilization. Internal fertilization and the second is the external fertilization. Internal fertilization takes place inside the body . It is found in higher animals such as in humans, cat, dog, goat, etc. This is the internal fertilization, in which two gametes are required. One is the sperm and second is the ovum. The sperm comes from the male side, father, and the female gamete, egg or ovum, comes from the female side. Both fuse together to form a single structure called zygote. Later on we will discuss in detail about the sexual reproduction. I am giving just the introduction of internal fertilization. Now I am giving the introduction of external fertilization. Takes place outside the body mainly in aquatic animals. Such as fish, frog, etc. Well, now it is clear what is internal fertilization and external fertilization. Understand? Once again, I am repeating the whole chapter, the whole topic. Reproduction is the fundamental characteristics of all living things. It is essential for the survival of life on this earth. It is essential for the continuation of species on the earth. If there will be no reproduction, the life on the earth will be empty. There will be no life on this earth. It is the answer of death. The death takes an organism away from the earth, and the reproduction add the new organism. Understand? So life will be continue on this earth. Even a person, a plant, a cat, a dog die, but another will come to take their place. So life will be continue on this earth by reproduction. So reproduction is very essential for the continuation of a species. What is a species? A species is the group of similar individuals which live together and they interbreed in nature to produce offspring. Interbreeding means a man can interbreed with another man, a dog can interbreed with another dog, a dog cannot interbreed with the goat. That is why I am adding this word. Interbreeding is very essential character of the species. Understand? So reproduction is very essential for the continuation of life. I have given just an introduction about the reproduction and its importance and the types of the fertilization and its type. In next class, we will read in detail about the sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction, their main organs and their functions. Till now, goodbye and stay healthy.